Hi, what's up? I'm Simon HC and welcome to our next lecture. Today, Environment Creation Part 1. And in this tutorial, we are going to learn how to create highly detailed plants models using 3ds Max, V-Ray, Photoshop and the base tools. I would like to show you how easy it is to transfer the techniques to other plants so you can see the skills to build up your very own library of models. And the presented scene is the result of a collaboration with the Nadula Vern Studio that have designed the buildings. And my task was to create an image that would be able to express the ambience created by various elements of the environment. So from the very beginning, the plants were the focal point of the scene, because their type and position was clearly specified. I had to work out some new techniques that allowed me to complete this task with accurate results. And I wanted to make the scene unique, so, you know, to brand the idea in the viewer's memories. And this tutorial will explain how using reference pictures and basic 3ds Max techniques can create plant models just like those shown and on the illustrations. We will also go through the V-Ray rendering engine and material options to polish up the image for the best results in Photoshop. So let's start with the groundwork. And as you can see, the scenes have been published many times and probably you got a bit bored, but I hope the technique will allow you, you know, to choose your own way how to create your plants and a bit different scenes. So I had here also some moss plants, you know, wisteria plants and many others. So let's start with the plant modeling. And we need to plan the work. So the first thing we need to do is to find some reference pictures that will allow us to understand the anatomy of a particular plant, which in this case is Japanese wisteria. That's Latin probably, Wisteria floribunda. Anyway, just to be sure to find good pictures showing your focal object from different angles and scales, and try to find shots that will be also orthogonal to each specific part of the plant, like the leaves or shoots. This process will aid you with the textures in the following steps and can also be a great help with the modeling process. So in the basic shape definitions, we are planning how to create a pretty large scene, including lots of plants. So we need to think about the poly count in the first place to make sure that our workstation can actually manage with the size of the scene. It's important to answer the question which elements need more and less detail to make them work in regular shots as well as close-ups. In this case, we have four main objects: flowers, shoots, leaves, and branches. So choose your modeling technique, and in my case, I have used the poly, editable poly technique. And once we have defined the necessary elements, we need to start the modeling process. So most single components can be created the very basic techniques. In this instance, I have chosen the editable poly. To make the plants more natural, we will need a few variations of the same elements to make sure nothing is repeated. We also need to use some extra tools to scatter single elements in a random way. In the presented scene, we did not use blueprints. We simply focus on the reference images and try to retain the general forms. The flower consisted of three elements. Create a simple plane object and add new divisions to obtain the low poly shape of the main body. Follow the same procedure to prepare the petals and core, and in the end, we'll need a shoot that will connect the flower to the stalk. Copy the flower twice and change the geometry a little to give, you know, more variety. And that's basically the idea how to go from a low poly geometry into a more detailed one, and depending on that depth we can choose the type of the model, and this way we can also win some polys and make the scene work better on your workstation. Once the main elements of the flower are done, apply a UVW map to each object. And I have used a simple box mapping procedure. So create the necessary maps, shaders, and apply to your models. Next, convert the geometry into editable poly and attach all the components into one object. And please make sure to adjust the pivot so the Z-axis is placed exactly as shown in the example. So this is a very important stage, so take your time and make sure everything is correct, because sometime later we will use the Advanced Painter tool, and thanks to this we can easily spread the leaves, the flowers in the right position. Here are some textures I have created using the reference pictures and some slightly painting in Photoshop. And on this example you see how the pivot point has been adjusted to the shoot to sometime later multiply it in the correct way using the V-Ray Advanced script, the Advanced Painter script. And the Z-axis is following actually the shoot, so sometime later we will paint it on the stalk and it will remain orthogonal to the stalk. And this is the base idea, how to spread those elements very easily and fast using this script. So just remember, when you're done with the modeling and all objects have a proper UVW and nice textures and mapping, then we need to convert all the objects into editable poly and attach into one object. And just remember in the end to fix the pivot point so we can easily use it in Advanced Painter script. Now it's time for the stalk and leaf creation. So in this step we will create the stalk object and some leaves. The actions in this step are pretty much the same as in the basic flower creation process, so basic editable poly technique. And first you can use a spline to draw the stalk and leaf. Then you can copy just twice or three times and tweak the size to have a slightly different shape. You can create three different lengths of stalk to produce, you know, plants in various stages of development. So, you know, just young stalks and then in some bit older ages. And we can also take care when adjusting the pivot point also right here. So in the end we will receive some groups of the model plants, and we can also once again use the Advanced Painter script to spread the elements all over your scene. And after your geometry has been created into groups, converted into groups, we can proceed with the V-Ray Mesh export to create proxies. So just to be sure, using the Advanced Painter script, you may spread the leaves and flowers on the stalk. And you have to set the Advanced Painter to randomizer mode and select the correct object to multiply. So be sure to check the align up direction is set to N, so it's the normal. And remember to use stalks with different lengths so you have a more random result. And once you have created similar groups to those shown, convert the objects into editable poly, attach them into one object, and once again carefully adjust the pivots until it looks right. In this step, we will create branches and we will take care of their distribution. and using the great GuruWare plugin called EV Generator, we will now create the branches. And in the scene, we have some cables in the courtyard that the branches can follow. And this might be not enough, though, to cover the whole sky. So we'll create a fake distribution object, which you will see in the presented scene after the presentation. And to do so, use just simple a circle from the splines rollout and convert it into editable poly. And you can just go also to the object properties and set this object as not visible to camera, because it's only a helper that will allow us to spread the objects all over the sky. And we can just use now the Advanced Painter script and paint all over the sky the groups we have just created. And we can use the proxies, you know, to have the scene a bit lighter. And we can repeat this action few times until the density is thick enough. And we can also place some branches on the ground and columns too, you know, to have the idea of the growing plants all over the place. And remember to uncheck the leaf option in the EV setting, because we only want to have branches. So a quick view on the helper object that will allow us to create nice EVs on the top of the scene. And you know, the cables might be not enough, so that's why we have decided to create one more object. And this object will only help us to spread the EVs, because in the end it will not be visible during the rendering. Now it's time to establish the scene. So at this point, all plants are ready to spread into the scene. So we have used the V-Ray Mesh Export option to create proxies from the predefined groups from step 7. And once again, we will use Advanced Painter to spread all the geometry. So we just need to run the script and choose the flower proxy, select the instance cloning method and distribution object from step 8, and paint the flowers, tweak the rotation, position and scale in Advanced Painter setting. And you may also want to set this time a fixed amount of the distribution, so not a normal, because we have some cables that are not actually placed into one surface, because they are going a bit down into the patio, and we want all EVs, you know, to be just following the gravity, so perfectly vertical. And then you can set just in the Advanced Painter tool the N to Z axis, so they will be always perfect vertical. And in the end, once your camera is set up in the scene, you can also add some more groups to areas where they will be well exposed, like, you know, some very small groups like here on the presented image. And you may also want to add additional details on the ground. And in this case, the client wanted to have some moss plants on the ground. And to create these elements, I have used once again the Advanced Painter script. So I have created in editable poly a simple strand in a Y shape. And over a hemisphere, I have just spread with the script the strands and created a kind of moss effect. And in the end, I have created proxies from this geometry and spread all over the terrain like in the previous steps. So now it's time for textures, shaders and the post-production work. And as you remember, in the early steps we have applied UVW box mapping to the main components such as flowers and stalk. It's a massive help to have reference pictures taken from orthogonal views for the elements you're about to texture. There is a great plugin called TextPorter, which may help when creating texture templates. And once the template is ready, you can simply copy a part of the reference picture and fit it to the comp in Photoshop or other favorite composition software. And it's actually very easy than to fit the shader to the object, and you have also more control over the size and placement. And let's check out some shaders. And after your diffuse textures are done, copy the layers and desaturate them. Tweak the contrast and brightness to prepare the bump reflection and translucence map in Photoshop. Once all the textures are set, choose the V-Ray material and organize the channels as shown on this picture. To get more control over the shader's behavior, use the color correct parameter with all created textures or just the color correction plugin. During the post-production, we may need some other channels also. So we may save the raw reflections, refraction, and also the Z-Depth channel. And in the previous lectures, we have learned how to use the Z-Depth channel to create the depth of field effect. And we can use a simple filter inside of Photoshop, which is the lens blur. And we can choose your alpha created from the Z-Depth channel to control the focal point. And tweaking the settings inside of this filter, you may achieve nice bokeh effects and the desired depth of field. So it's a great help. And right now, let's jump into the next section. Let's check out the real scene in 3ds Max.